State College East Campus.
Hello, welcome to the Small Business Hotline. I'm your host, Ned Harper, and tonight's show is on profiting from event business. How can businesses in our community take advantage of the huge market increases during special events? The Small Business Development Centers throughout Florida help clients get information necessary to enjoy business success. For this show, we have two members of a legendary events business, family business, Rossmeyer's. Bruce Rossmeyer, owner of Destination Daytona and Daytona Harley-Davidson, and Shelly Rossmeyer Pepe, general manager and owner of Shelly Rossmeyer Motorcycles of Daytona. Well, Bruce, tell us how you got into the motorcycle business in Daytona Beach here.
Well, we lived in Daytona and been in the car business all my life. My father's been in the car business, so I grew up in it. And I've always said, the car business is what I wanted to do from the day I went to school. And being here in Daytona over the years, I always owned motorcycles, and my kids own motorcycles, and probably bought 10 or 15 motorcycles from Joe Robinson, and heard he wanted to sell the dealership, and I went in to Joe, and I said, Joe, I'd like to buy the dealership. And he says, well, I have two or three other people that, you know, I've talked to. He's been in it for 30 years, and he was about ready to retire, and so he called me up and said, here was the price that I had, so I told him I'd give him a little bit more money on it. I bought the dealership and pretty much did it at first just to mess around on weekends as a hobby because I enjoyed it. Mm-hmm. Well, after it being Sundays and Mondays and Tuesdays, it became a full-time job and pretty much got into it and said, hey, I'm going to take this to another level, not just Daytona, take it elsewhere, buy more dealerships, and that's pretty much what I started to doing.
Well, that's really unusual what you did there. I mean, in the motorcycle industry, wasn't it, at that time?
Well, this is pretty much in the car business. There's been many dealers that have multi-dealerships that own 8, 9, 10 dealerships.
Mm-hmm. That's common.
And I said, nobody has taken it in the motorcycle business, has then, and has not yet. And so I said, well, I could do it. I think I had the knowledge and the experience of seeing my friends and people and working for people that have done it. So I said, well, geez, why don't I do this in the motorcycle business, which at the time it wasn't something that people have even thought about, and Harley had a lot of restrictions on it, and mm-hmm. Owning so many dealerships in the car business, you can own 50. The Harley-Davidson had some restrictions, so you're only allowed to have so many, but then, you know, put one in my daughter's name, Shelly, one of my son's name, Will, one of my niece's name, Lisa, and just start beating the system, and so far it's worked.
That's one of the keys in business is innovation.
Yeah,
figure out what the system is and figure out
how to work within it.
You know, you're not breaking the rules.
You're just working around.
Now you've been, through all of this growing up in this industry. Can you remember some of the key points?
I definitely remember the key points of when my dad decided to buy the motorcycle dealership, and working for him in the car business and knowing the transition was about to take place, I was very excited, and I remember him giving us his plans for the future, and for example, Destination Daytona, which has just been completed in the last few years. So definitely the most important thing was just seeing how the community accepted and just went with it with the events and everything. So it's been great.
Well, the events, I mean, that's mainly what I want to get into tonight, but they grew out of this. You started off with just taking a dealership and expanding it, and then somehow you morphed into event business. How did you get in the event business?
Well, you could sit here and say it was a plan, or I thought about it, and I didn't really think about it. It just happened. And pretty much going to being in Daytona and watching the events grow, and we were very fortunate when I bought Daytona Harley, it was the year after Biketoberfest, which they were trying, not they, the city, was trying to form another event like Bike Week. So mm-hmm. as they were trying to do that, I sort of got in on the coattails of them doing it and say, well, how can I help them and benefit for the city and benefit for me? And Biketoberfest has been in it for 1 year. And being down at Beach Street, really, it was Main Street is where all the events took place. Mm-hmm. Right. Mm-hmm. There wasn't events at the Speedway, so that was really it. And they had a couple little, other locations down at Miller's and South Daytona. So I made a deal with the city and rented the park across the street. and started off with two or three vendors and four, five or six vendors, and going to the other motorcycle rallies of bringing them to Daytona, which there was nothing on Beach Street at that time. We had the Chrysler Plymouth that basically went out, and you had Lloyd Buick that had been there for years, and a lot of empty stores. So as other motorcycle industry moved into the other end of Beach Street, it became bigger and bigger, and got some people that knew what they were doing of bringing in events, got them, went to different rallies, and before you know it, when we opened up the first year, you could park pretty much anywhere on Beach Street. There was parking anywhere. 10 years later, you couldn't park anywhere on Beach Street or anywhere within a mile or 2 miles of it. The park was full, and you know, then I said, okay, now we've outgrown this, what do we do now? We can't do it. Didn't have the room. Mm-hmm. You know, there's no more room at the location that I had. And said, well, geez, moving out somewhere else, found the property out on 95, and started off as an old Howard Johnson's rundown hotel, and got bigger and bigger, and then property next to it got bigger and bigger, and before you know it, we had 150 acres, and it happened and just made it grow, and with the help of good people and good advice, it worked. At the time, I wouldn't believe it, but today it's worked out.
Now, did anybody kind of think you were a little crazy there? That was some big jumps.
It was a big jump, just like when I built the Dodge store out in the, right across from the Speedway, right down the street from here, and you know, that was what, 1972, 73, and people said, this guy, there was nothing out here but the dog track and the Speedway. Mm-hmm. And people said, this guy's lost his rocker, and when we built it, and I said earlier there that when they put a Wendy's out here, we were loving life. It was like a hike downtown, but everything grew out here. Well, it's sort of what we'll say at destination. They say that more people live west of 95 and 5 years from now that live in Ormond Beach now. So you have no place to go but out in that area for the growth. And with what we did, everything else is building around it. There was nothing out there. And I think the people around there has benefit from it. Mm-hmm. And it's right on the highway. And you know, there's probably 70,000 people a day that go by there that don't even know Daytona exists. So you know, it's been good for us and good for the city.
Now, you've been involved, you know, for many years in it, and you've had your own business that you had to grow. Mm-hmm. Have you done some things with events, or how have you been involved in tuning your business into the event opportunities?
Well, you definitely have to take advantage of it. We are so fortunate in our area to even have two events in the motorcycle industry. There's some dealerships that don't have these events, so they have to work harder trying to get people into their store. We're fortunate that they come into the area. Now we've got to just keep the people coming back and earning the business. And in doing that, you just have to hire really good people and take advantage of the people that you have potential business, you know, that you can earn their potential business.
So what have been some of the key things, the performers or the products, or
definitely stocking the inventory, having, you know, if it's in the case of motorcycles, you have to have a lot of choices. People want to be able to choose from a big inventory, so you have to take the chance of stocking the inventory, and that's definitely been our success, I believe, is having the inventory from the leather jackets to the motorcycle inventory to t-shirt sales. I mean, it's amazing how many t-shirt sales you'll sell during an event, you know. And people want event t-shirts. They want to kind of go home with the date and where they were and what they were doing. So, for sure.
So they're advertising for you, right?
Yes.
All over the country, all over the world.
What Shelly is saying, what's good too, is you go into your local Harley store and they might have 5 leather jackets. Well, if Harley makes 100, we have 100. People, they deal their local dealers, but they come here during Bike Week because they know if Harley makes it, we have it. It makes a big difference, you know, because number one, they don't have the room. We didn't have the room when we were on Beach Street. You had a 20,000 square foot store, now I got a 109,000 square foot store, plus mm-hmm. that. And we have everything that, you know, Harley has. And bringing in all the other vendors, not necessarily Harley, whether being had in the Arlen Ness when the custom business, or have, you know, different makes, different parts, different. We have now JP Cycles that is out there.
Right.
Well, they handle everything Harley doesn't have. everybody said, well, why would you build competition on your own property? Well, we're trying to make it a Disney. Anything that's connected with Harley, we have, whether it's an aftermarket part or something else. People want to buy a Harley, or if they want to buy at Shelly's store, they want to buy a Triumph or a Ducati or want to buy a custom bike, they can come there. And as we get more people in there, that one-stop shopping, and this is really what we're trying to do.
And I've really enjoyed going into your store and seeing the Ducatis and the Triumphs and some amazing customs.
Yeah.
And a lot of the other there's just pretty much anything you could want in there.
There's so much in this industry, and it really is only fair to say that, you know, people are into all different types of motorcycles, and if you can offer a few stores and all the potential, you know, accessories and things like that, it's exciting. People are into that. So,
well, let's say I have a business and it's not motorcycle business. It may be a restaurant, it may be some. How can I take advantage of all of these people? There's, what is there, 500,000 people come for Bike Week?
Well, I don't know how they count it, but, you know, they say 500, they say 600, you know. It's just to be there.
A lot of people.
Well, it is. I mean, that's why Daytona has been noted for tourism. And we have to, as the city and the people, you have to cater to tourism. This is how Daytona survives. Mm-hmm. I mean, we have not only Bike Week, we have Speed Week, or we have this week. And you bring these people in, the money that's spent during that time is just phenomenal. Mm-hmm. So you have to be ready for it. You got to be prepared for it. You got to cater to them. You got to take care of the people. You got to have them welcome them here. And, you know, we have a problem now in Myrtle Beach. They're trying to kill Bike Week. And when they go into that, you know, you're just turning away people. And the more people don't want to go to Myrtle Beach, maybe more people come to Daytona. You know, tourism is there. Bike Week has been here for years. It's a little, you know, as I said, if I wasn't in the bike business, you hear the noise. Well, I'm not complaining about the noise, but because it's good business. But we have to put up with it a little bit. It is a little inconvenience to people that live here, but look what it does for the people. Look what it does for the city, for the taxes, the income. So it's just something. Speed Week, same thing. Mm-hmm. You got 2 weeks. We're in Speed Week right now. Mm-hmm. Traffic, jams, and everything, but then we get into Bike Week. But then after that, everything dies again, but then you got to reap the rewards that everybody in town, the restaurants, I don't care what kind of business you're in, you got to take advantage of it with it, because if I get 500,000 people in town, they're going to come to destination once or twice. Mm-hmm. There is another dealers that get 500,000 people in the dealership in 5 years.
Right.
So we're very fortunate.
And I like what Shelly was saying, that maybe I can't sell motorcycles at my restaurant, but I could sell T-shirts.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And you really sell a service. I mean, when we go out of town, we want to feel welcome, period. And when people come and spend money to come to a rally or they want to walk around, they just want to have that feeling of, I can go into that restaurant. If I have to go get my laundry done, I can go into the laundromat. And they're welcoming bikers. They're welcoming, you know, the tourist at all. So.
Well, I know everywhere I go, whether it's a park, you know, or anything, there's a lot of people there. And the smart ones do what you've done. You say, what do these people want? And they have it available for them. So if I have a restaurant, I could have cool T-shirts. Or I could have other things that they may want to buy, add on, you know, to my sales.
Well, it's just welcome, again, as the signs in Daytona, welcome bikers. We're here, I always say, just treat Daytona like you treat your own city. Have fun, but enjoy yourself, but give Daytona and Daytona residents the same respect you would do on your own street. Mm-hmm. You know, and again, have fun, but again, they want to be welcomed. And if they're welcomed, they're going to come back, whether they're going into a hardware store, or they're going into a restaurant, or coming into a Harley store. And they're here for a good time, and they're here. Nobody spends more money than bikers. They spend a lot of money, and it just does great for the city and the economy of this area.
And I know I grow up here, and when I go on vacation, I want to have a good time. So I think about them. You know, they're here. They're spending a lot of money to be here. I want to take that extra step to make it a positive experience for them so that they come back. And I know I'm going to benefit, because do you think we have more restaurants here because of all these events and all that extra business that comes in?
Well, it does. There's no doubt about it. When you turn around the amount, I just compare in our business the amount of what we do under two events or three events, say in Speed Week, Biketoberfest, on the amount of sales we do in those months is just phenomenal. And as Shelly said earlier, we're very fortunate. You have a dealer in Hoboken, Idaho, you know, he just doesn't get that traffic. He has to live mm-hmm. off of what is there in that town. You know, somebody's not going to turn around there 100 miles away or 200 miles to go down there. They'll deal with their local people. So we're very fortunate, and the city of Daytona is very fortunate that we have these events.
Well, I would think even other events like Speed Week mm-hmm. and yes. some of these golf tournaments, your business yeah. would increase.
Everything increases when there's yeah. bodies.
Yeah.
Yep.
Yeah. So any business could take the same advantage that you do. I mean, golfers may or may not ride motorcycles, but they're going to come out to your place.
They will.
Because you're going to yep. market for them to do
and,
that.
You know, Dad said he said it, and we kind of laugh about it, but, you know, like Walt Disney probably said, if we build this, people are going to come. They're going to want to check it out. That was his vision, is if I build this, people will come. And whether they have any interest in motorcycles or they're driving down 95 and they see a few billboards on the way down, you know, maybe I'll stop there. So it's definitely worked.
Now, do you remember what you told me was one of the reasons she's been so successful? Her passion.
No.
Because she loves doing it.
Well, it's very important. And with fortunately having three of my kids in the business and with Shelly, and I said, hey, if this is what you want to do, you know, I mean, I'm, you know, as I said, I'm on Social Security and Medicare now. I'm just loving life, you know.
He's so in a rocking chair, right?
Yeah. Now the question is, do they want to do it? You know, yeah. What do? Do you go try to sell it to Joe Schmo, or, you know, kids, do you want to do this? And there's a lot of businesses that family come into it, don't work out. They're in it because the father or mother want them to do it. They're not mm-hmm. really happy. If you're happy, tell me. If you're not happy, let's work on a different plan. And as we keep going and growing, the kids love it. They want to be in it, and they want to take.
Happy.
Yeah, happy.
And when they yeah. have that passion, they do.
The passion is very important. You know, I've always in the car business and the motor. I love what I do. I always said the car business is a job. The motorcycle business is fun. I enjoy it. I go to work. I enjoy the atmosphere. I enjoy the people, and it's something I enjoy doing. And when I stop enjoying doing it, then I'm not going to do it anymore.
So are you saying if I have a laundromat, I could make that a destination?
We'll find room for it.
No, but what I'm saying is the same vision, the same passion, yeah. the same thing you've done could be transferred to other businesses.
It can be.
Because you look forward to those people coming in.
Yeah, you have to. You can sit here and say, did you have a vision? How did it happen? Did you wake up one morning with a performer? Well, I'm not that educated to come up. You got to be at the right place. You have to have good people, be a little lucky, and you got to take a shot. You got to take a chance. The people that don't take a chance and take a gamble, stay where they're at, exist, and don't look for what's down the road, but you got to take a shot to get there. And sometimes it doesn't always work. Mm-hmm. You got to take a gamble and be at the right place at the right time. And the biggest thing is just surround yourself with good people. If you have good people say, how do you have all these dealerships? You know, I got 15 locations. How do you? Well, I have good people, and I don't ask them to do anything I wouldn't do, and they enjoy working, and they have the opportunity down the road. But you got to surround yourself with good people, and that's the key.
Well, tell me a little bit about Shelly Rossmeyer Motorcycles of Daytona.
Well, we've just recently changed into this. We have been carrying the Triumph and Ducati brands for the last few years and have done very well with it. And now we're bringing in Buell, which has been located in the Harley dealership. We're bringing that into this location, and it is just adjacent to the Harley dealership out at Destination Daytona. And we're getting into the racing, the AMA racing, motorcycle racing. So I think That's the new deal, and I'm very excited about it. I love all the different motorcycles that I'm selling now, and as well having Harley Davidson as kind of what's trained me and gotten me to where I am today. So I believe Just now, I go to work looking at my name on the building every day, so it should be exciting.
Is this a different demography? I mean, different age group and or
no,
different type?
If anything, type it's just it just joins the whole motorcycle enthusiast. And, you know, there are other brands out there, but it's definitely, I mean, quite a few of my Harley customers actually drive Ducati, Triumphs, and other of their manufacturers that we sell too. So, but that's what the store is just, it's a more of a performance store. That's what we'll try to build it up into, is taking the performance side of it. So you've got, you know, we run all of our service department and everything under the Harley dealership. So if you come in and get a Ducati, a Buell, a Triumph, or mm-hmm. a Harley Davidson, you're going into the Harley Davidson dealership. So we're really two separate stores, but under one organization.
Tell them about with the racing and what you said on here, that we got involved with the racing, and now that the Jimmy France has taken over in some of the racing, which they'll be racing in a couple weeks here. We have two bikes in the racing, and last
oh, wow.
we
That's
have
cool.
one of them sponsored by Geico, and we're doing another ourselves, so we'll have a two team. So not as maybe as big as the NASCAR deal, but it's similar, just in a motorcycle deal. And mm-hmm. that's something, that breed of people is a different, you know, we say the age limit of Harley people are, you know, getting older and little there, and the people in her business and the Triumph Ducati, and they have both, but that's more, you see all the, what we say, the crotch rockets and the kids on it. So this is a whole, right, this is a new field. Mm-hmm. And by having that, we bring everybody out. You just have the Harley owner. But now with really getting into this and not have it as a second class citizen, that will be a whole new breed of customers that go into that, and then hope eventually they into that, they come into the Harley. So it's just bringing some more stuff into destination to, as we said, a Disney World of the motorcycle business.
Now, we just have a couple minutes left, and I just want to touch base on, you know, I really admire, you know, the vision, and I know that word's over, but we all know what it means. If someone sees that something could be, they see it the way it could be, and they have the guts to go make it happen. But sometimes people get blocked. So they want to get into event, they want to do this, and maybe they can't get a license, or maybe they can't get a permit, or they can't do this. How do you handle it when you're blocked, when you want to do, get into the event business?
You can't, you say can't. That word's not in my vocabulary. You know, you say can't, you can. You just have to find a way. And mm-hmm. sometimes there's obstacles and you got to overcome them. And some people don't want to take the time to do it or the effort to do it. So, I mean, there's nothing that you can't do if you really want to do. You just got to, you know, just go for it and just keep unplugging till you, you know, hit the right button.
And see, I think that's a biggie. A lot of people, you know, they say, oh, well, this is a dead end street. And the really successful ones turn around and say, well, there's got to be another one
come
over
in
here
another
somewhere.
Way.
And they drive over there or they drive over there. And finally, they get to their destination. But others said, well, you can't get there from here.
Right.
And they just stop. So when there's a ordinance or a regulation, you know, what is the rule? What is, you know, how do we make this happen?
Well, as we said, I said earlier, with the obstacles that I had with Harley of owning more than X dealerships. Well, you overcome them, you work the system. Mm-hmm. And there is a system. Every rules are made, let's say, not to be broken, but then you gotta turn around and find a way to overcome it.
And sometimes it's just understanding why they have the rule.
Yeah.
So they didn't want you to go down this street because there was a house there. But over on this other street, there's not a house. So you just find
out. And
you
do, like Dad said, you just have to take chances and you have to see the next, the big picture. I think in any business, from restaurants to hotels, if you want it to be better, then you just have to go for it. And people will follow that. They see your drive and it almost, in a sense, brings them to want to spend their money with you. I mean, people have said that to me all the time. I want to spend money here because I know that it costs money to build this and to make this, and that's important.
Well, you know, I think that's real important, especially in this economy, in this mm-hmm. time. Hurricanes don't put you out of business. This economy won't put you out of business. You've got to keep working at it. Mm-hmm. I want to thank Shelly and Bruce. I want to thank you so much for being here tonight and sharing your experiences with event businesses. For business training and planning, visit your local SBDC at www.floridasbdc.com. Thank you for watching, and we'll see you next week on the Small Business Hotline. That went pretty fast. I really